Camila Binti Kamarzamai, and my supervisor is Dr. Nur Abiza Binti Badaluddin. As for today, I will be presenting about potential of penicillin species as a biofertilizer for soil fertility improvement in phylogenetic corpus plantation. So this is the table content. So let's begin with the background of study. Phylogenetic corpus plantation of Ladang Rakyat Terengganu Sdn Bhd is located in Cernik, Kemaman, Terengganu. And this plantation owns favored and non-favored soil. So the soil series, the non-favored one, is infertile soil that caused by overuse of chemical fertilizer and improper land preparation. Thus, it decreased the oil palm yield and quality. So, to solve the problem, penicillin species is used as a substitute for the chemical fertilizer that will affect and improve the soil fertility. Next, for the problem statement, there is too much reliance on chemical fertilizer usage, and the other one is improper land preparation and management that cause high acidity in soil, thus lowering the production of oil palm. So as you can see in the plantation map of Ladang Rakyat Terengganu Sdn Bhd, this is a phylogenetic oil palm plantation, and it is seen that it has the worst soil quality among four oil palm plantations under Ladang Rakyat Terengganu. And everything here, as we see that the phylogenetic oil palm is below the pH, CEC, and average feed is below optimum level. So next is the significance of study. Penicillin species shows potential as a biofertilizer for oil palm, and this study also shows potential to promote a sustainable agriculture, and it is an environmentally friendly method. So the objective of this study comprises three, which is first to identify penicillin species by using a molecular approach. Next is to characterize problematic soil from phylogenetic oil palm plantation. And the last one is to evaluate the effectiveness of penicillin species for fertility improvement on problematic soil. So, moving on to the literature review, I'll briefly explain the two major points from this study, which is oil palm and penicillin. First, for oil palm, or Elais guineensis, it is a monoecious tree, since the male and female flowers are on the same tree. And there are three types of oil palm, which is Dura, Piscifera, and Tinera. Regarding its soil, oil palm favor sandy clay and clay of soil texture, and the common topography and slope for this oil palm plantation are flat to hilly. So the problems of soil in oil palm is first the artisanal soil, which is the famously known of oil palm soil. It has a high degree of low fertility, and the other one is deficit excess and imbalanced soil nutrient could also become the primary stress for oil palm. So next is literature review. So next is penicillin species. Penicillin species is a root-shaped cell, and it is a motile bacteria. Being a biofertilizer, this penicillin is used to enhance crop growth and environmental sustainability by facilitating the release of complicated soil minerals into a simpler form. So, penicillin gives so much benefits such as phosphate and potassium solubilization, atmospheric nitrogen fixation, and also micronutrient uptake in rhizosphere region. So for its efficacy, first, from my readings, first, many Bacillus species help increase plant growth performance when inoculated with cucumber seedlings. And the other one is one of the many Bacillus species, which is P. polymoxa. It fixes nitrogen by reducing nitrous oxide, N2O, without compromising the tea quality, as you can see here. Okay. So moving on to methodology, it will follow the objective of this study, which is first, identify many Bacillus species using molecular approach, to characterize problematic soil from phylogenetic or compensation, and to evaluate the effectiveness of penny bacillus for fertility improvement. So following the objective one, which is identify using a molecular approach, three major steps will be done, which is DNA extraction, next is amplification by polymerase chain reaction using this RhinoTest, and the last one is DNA sequencing using BLAST and NCBI. The second objective, characterization of rheumatic soil will be done, and as we can see here, six different soil series will be taken, and there are three favorite soil and three non-favorite soil series, which is the favorite one is Bungo, Renggang, and Seletar, and the non-favorite one is Batu Lapan, Lubuk Itik, and Gong Cengak. And the equipment for sampling soil is pH meter, EC meter, and soil auger. So following the objective 3, which is evaluate the effectiveness of penny bacillus species, two major steps will be done, which is preparation of bacterial granule using bacterial suspension, sucrose, potato starch, and kaolin. And the next one is treating the soil sample. So for objective 2 and 3, soil sampling and soil characterization will be done. After sampling the soil, the untreated soil and treated soil will be characterized to determine its EC, pH, and micronutrient and macronutrient. So the depth of soil that will be taken from the sampling is 0 to 15 cm, and random sampling will be done. For the expected outcome, penny bacillus species will be identified using molecular approach, and it is expected to be a great biofertilizer for improving soil fertility, and problematic soil of phylogenetic alpine will be analyzed and characterized, and will be treated. So this is the references from the set report, and this is my gun chart. So I actually have started the culturing of bacteria, the two species of penny bacillus, but not yet identified, and the sampling of soil has been done in phylogenetic competition. So that is all from me. Thank you.
Okay, now I will open for Q&A session.
Thank you, Nabila. Okay, similar with your previous friends, but only difference in Bacillus species, yeah? So, in terms of Bacillus and Penny Bacillus, from your readings, what is actually the difference between these two species?
There is not much different, but in my readings, the Bacillus is more on the phytohormone production, and the penny bacillus is more to the nitrogen fixation, such as bacillus, polymoxa, bacillus azotofisin.
In terms of the different characteristics, in terms of growing, condition, you know, emotions, what are some of the other
characteristics? Same.
Okay, can we go back to your objective 3 methodology part?
Thank you, Nabila, for excellent presentation. Next, I will call the next presenter.